Mercury has a tail like comet. Although it may not seem like it, Mercury, the planet closest to the Sun, leaves behind long, faint trails similar to comets. The interaction between solar radiation and the sodium present on the surface of Mercury causes this fascinating phenomenon. The discovery of this planetary tail occurred in 2001, when astronomers using ground-based telescopes equipped to detect specific light noticed a faint yellow-orange emission around the planet. Later, NASA's Messenger mission confirmed its existence and revealed its structure in detail. But how does it work? The intense solar wind and the Sun's extreme ultraviolet radiation hit Mercury's surface and release sodium atoms. The pressure of sunlight pushes these atoms, spreading them out in a tail that can reach up to 24 million kilometers into space. This phenomenon is unique because, unlike comets, Mercury's tail is not made of ice or dust, but of atomic gas coming from its rocky surface. Isn't it amazing how a seemingly quiet planet can have such a spectacular feature? What would all the other planets with tails like comets look like? Sulfuric acid rain on Venus. Yes, this planet, often called the evil twin of Earth, has such an extreme and hostile atmosphere that it's fascinating. Venus's dense carbon dioxide atmosphere, which contains large amounts of sulfur dioxide and water vapor, causes sulfuric acid rain. These compounds react chemically to form sulfuric acid clouds at high altitudes, where temperatures are lower. Tiny drops of this acid fall as rain. However, due to hellish temperatures reaching 470 degrees Celsius at the surface, rain evaporates before it hits the ground in a process called thermal evaporation. This phenomenon was discovered thanks to missions such as Venera from the Soviet Union and later confirmed by space probes such as NASA's Magellan. Venus is unique because its atmosphere is incredibly dense. It is also the hottest planet in the solar system, surpassing even Mercury, the closest planet to the Sun. Can you imagine a world where the heat scorches and rains acid that never touches the ground? If Venus is this extreme, could any living thing survive in such a place? Earth is the only planet that emits light. Although we were taught at school that planets do not emit light, the Earth breaks this rule. Unlike the other worlds of the solar system, which remain in complete darkness on their night side, our planet emits artificial light, visible even from space. This light comes from our cities, roads, and other human activities, and is a unique phenomenon in the known universe. The discovery of this terrestrial glow was made possible by space missions and satellites in orbit, such as those launched by NASA. Photographers and astronauts aboard the International Space Station, the ISS, have captured stunning images of the Earth illuminated by city lights at night. This phenomenon occurs because artificial lights created by humans, mainly from urban lamps, infrastructure, traffic, and cities, escape into space and appear faintly on the surface. What makes this so special is that no other planet so far observed shows signs of artificial light or technological activity. This feature not only reflects our ingenuity, but also points to the impact the human race has had on the planet. If extraterrestrial beings observed Earth, what would they think when they saw our planet glow in the dark? Could this light be a signal that tells the aliens that very special beings live here? Mars is the only planet that is inhabited solely by robots. Although no human has ever set foot on the surface of the red planet, Mars is full of robotic explorers who work tirelessly to unravel its mysteries. Robots and rovers sent by different space agencies have been the only inhabitants of this red planet for decades. It all started in 1997 when NASA sent Sojourner, the first rover to travel the Martian surface. Since then, we've seen increasingly advanced missions such as Spirit and Opportunity in 2004 that exceeded all expectations by traveling great distances and uncovering evidence that Mars had water in the past. Later in 2012, Curiosity arrived, equipped with scientific laboratories to analyze rocks and atmosphere, confirming that Mars may have been habitable in the past. In 2021, the Perseverance rover landed alongside the Ingenuity helicopter, achieving the first controlled flight on another planet. Perseverance continues to collect samples that could be brought back to Earth. This phenomenon is unique because Mars is the first planet where our technology has become uninhabitant to prepare the ground for future human missions. If robots are our pioneers on Mars, how long will it take for humans to follow in their footsteps and become true explorers of the red planet? Trojan asteroids, the companions of all planets. Did you know that there are asteroids that travel alongside planets without colliding with them? These are the Trojan asteroids, celestial companions that share a planet's orbit and are kept in stable positions thanks to a unique gravitational balance. Astronomers discovered this phenomenon in the 19th century when they identified the first Jupiter Trojans. They are located in two specific regions of their orbit, the L4 and L5 Lagrange points, which form an equilateral triangle with the planet and the Sun. At these points, the gravitational pull of the planet and the Sun balances out, allowing the asteroids to travel with the planet in a stable manner. Although Jupiter has the most known Trojans, thousands of them, other planets such as Neptune, Mars, and even Earth also have Trojans. Earth's Trojans, such as the 2010 asteroid TK7, are more challenging to detect due to their angular proximity to the Sun, but they confirm that we are not alone in our orbit. Trojans are unique with planets without colliding, which makes them unique, thanks to the gravitational dance at Lagrange points. If asteroids and planets can share orbits so harmoniously, what other secrets do these regions of cosmic balance hold in the solar system? Jupiter is the protector of the Earth. The largest planet in the solar system plays a crucial role in deflecting or trapping asteroids and comets that could harm our planet. This fantastic function is due to its powerful gravitational field, the strongest after the Sun. Jupiter's gravitational influence is so vast that it extends far beyond its orbit. It affects regions such as the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, and even objects from the distant Oort cloud or the Kuiper belt. Jupiter can deflect asteroids and comets into safe orbits or even capture them, preventing them from approaching Earth. Modern astronomical studies and observations of impact, such as the famous 1994 collision of comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 with Jupiter, confirm this ability. This event showed how the planet absorbs dangerous bodies. This phenomenon is so unique because without Jupiter, Earth would be much more exposed to catastrophic impacts. Its presence in the solar system is like a cosmic guardian that reduces threats from deep space. If Jupiter silently protects us from asteroids, where did the asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs come from? These Saturn moons share the same orbit without colliding. How is this possible? They are Janus and Epimetheus, two co-orbital moons that perform an incredible dance around the ring planet. This unique phenomenon in the solar system was confirmed in 1980 thanks to observations from the Voyager 1 mission. Unlike other moons with clearly separated orbits, Janus and Epimetheus orbit Saturn about the same distance from the planet, about 151,000 kilometers. So how did they manage to coexist without colliding? The key is in their gravitational interaction. Whenever one of these moons comes slightly closer to the other, about every 4 years, gravity causes them to swap positions. The moon, in a slightly closer orbit to the planet, receives a gravitational nudge that lifts it into a higher orbit while the other descends slightly. This continuous exchange prevents them from colliding and maintains their orbital balance. Janus and Epimetheus are unique because they are the only known moons in the solar system to achieve this precise orbital synchronization, a fascinating example of gravitational balance. Can you imagine two planets orbiting a star in the same orbit without colliding and doing the same dance that Janus and Epimetheus do? On Uranus, a day lasts 42 years. Can you imagine a day lasting 42 years? On Uranus, this is a reality. This icy giant planet has a unique phenomenon in the solar system due to its extreme inclination of almost 98 degrees regarding its orbit. This means that Uranus practically rolls around the Sun, with its poles alternating between receiving continuous sunlight and being plunged into an endless night. 1 year on Uranus is equivalent to 84 Earth years, and because of its tilt, each pole experiences 42 years of sunlight followed by 42 years of darkness. When one pole points toward the sun, it receives constant light for decades, while the other remains in shadow, frozen into a long night. As the planet moves forward in its orbit, the poles swap positions, creating unique day and night cycles. The enormous distance Uranus has from the sun, around 2.87 billion kilometers, also plays a role. The sunlight that reaches Uranus is 400 times dimmer than we receive on Earth, making even the illuminated days dark and cold. Could we ever imagine living in a world where dawn takes decades? Can you imagine having to wait 42 years for it to become daylight? Despina, the moon doomed to die. Did you know one moon of Neptune is doomed to disappear? We talk about Despina, one of Neptune's inner moons, in a dangerous orbit, slowly bringing it to its end. This moon, discovered in 1989 by the Voyager 2 probe, orbits just 52,500 kilometers from the center of Neptune, placing it below the radius of the planet's synchronous orbit. This phenomenon occurs because Despina is too close to Neptune. As it orbits, the gas giant's gravitational tidal forces act as a brake, slowing it down little by little. As a result, Despina's orbit spirals towards Neptune. Eventually, Despina will meet an inevitable fate. It could collide with the planet, or more likely, fragment as it crosses the Roche boundary, the point where Neptune's gravitational forces overcome the gravity that holds the moon together. If this happens, Despina will disintegrate into millions of pieces, creating a new ring system around Neptune, similar to Saturn's majestic ring. This unique destination highlights the dynamic and changing nature of our solar system. Will Despina be the beginning of a future ring show on Neptune, or will it merge with the blue giant? The Sun is not spherical. Did you know that the Sun is not a perfect sphere? Although it appears round to the naked eye, the Sun is flattened at its poles due to its rotation and the gravitational forces exerted by other celestial bodies, mainly Jupiter, the most massive planet in the solar system. This phenomenon is known as polar flattening, and although the Sun rotates slowly, once every 25 to 35 days depending on latitude, its rotation generates a slight deformation. Its equatorial diameter is slightly larger than the polar one. In addition, Jupiter's enormous gravity, despite being more than 778 million kilometers away, exerts a slight gravitational pull that affects the shape of the Sun and causes subtle oscillations on its surface. The precision of modern measurements, such as those made by space telescopes and solar observatories like SOHO and SDO, has made it possible to detect this deformation. It is practically imperceptible to the naked eye and can only be detected with high-precision instruments placed on telescopes. Despite the deformation, the Sun is still 99.999% spherical. This unique phenomenon shows us that even the largest and most dominant object in the solar system is not static or perfect, but responds to the forces around it. Have you ever imagined that a planet like Jupiter can influence the shape of a star? What other secrets could our solar system hide? Let us know what you think in the comments.